we're going to have more than one planet Earth, because we're talking about space and where is heaven and all.
Mm.
There isn't a place. It all exists at the same time. It's a hard concept for people to gather that there is already a fifth dimensional Earth there, all right? We're just, it's because if you consider there's no such thing as time, you can move yourself ahead to that. We're not supposed to do that until we are ready. It's a very hard concept for people to gather.
Well, I just say on this point, I remember seeing something about, if you consider the bands of a rainbow running through from red, orange, yellow, that different people will slot into their band that they're comfortable with.
Absolutely.
Some will remain within the red band, some in the orange band, some in the yellow. They all exist next to each other.
Paul, you said it exactly. Everyone's vibrating at different levels of them, according to how they live their lives, or whether they are nice to others, or whether they are cruel to others. Whatever role they happen to be playing, whatever level of advancement of their soul is, they will all shift, but they will shift into a vibration that is still comfortable to them. Because you can't put a very low vibration into a very high vibration without it being destroyed. It can't happen. So nobody is being penalised by being who they are. They will just be shifted into a vibration that they can cope with. Right? Now, those who can cope with the higher bands, like the rainbow, they shift into a higher band because they are already working towards it. But this is what this shift is about, this period of time. We are all gradually being adjusted so that we are ready and able to cope with the next vibration. Little shift, the big shift into the fifth dimension. Wonderful, wonderful, you know, nothing
so,
wrong with
so
that.
What are lower vibrations, lower emotions? What is keeping us within one particular band as opposed to moving up to another?
The way we behave towards others.
Okay.
And the planet, you know. I recommend to people who are worried about whether they will make it in the shift or not, whether they will still be stuck here, tell them to smile more. Just one smile at somebody else raises that other person's vibration and you get a feedback and you feel better, they feel better, you have already lifted.
The ripple effect, the butterfly effect.
The ripple effect.
Yes.
Be kind to somebody, even like opening the door for somebody. It doesn't have to be massive acts of martyrdom or anything. The little things, you know, helping somebody cross the road, helping somebody with it, doing nice things and being kind to people.
So the effort that you put in along those lines leads to the reward.
Yeah, absolutely. But if you're going to go around beating somebody up without any thought or consideration of them, because that is your nature, then you are most certainly going to stay in third dimensional world and have to deal with whatever that brings, because, you know, the Earth will have a bit of a shattering, the third dimensional Earth.
So looking at the book again, the book, using the techniques that you describe in your new book, gives you wisdom, inner wisdom, how to overcome...
It's the key.
...some of these lower emotions and lower dimensions.
Yes.
You're unlocking yourself.
You're unlocking yourself. If in the readers look at it as it's their journey, how they interpret that message that's been given, seeing it as their journey, each of them will understand it in different ways. So it's not for me to say, this is what it means. They have to find that within themselves, because it, in the end, it has to be your own journey. Nobody else can do this for you. Not a single solitary soul, no matter how much they want to help, can do your journey for you.
So those people who say, right, I'm going to go out and save the world and change everybody and change their views. Well, people have their own views.
Yeah,
and just listening to another person is not necessarily going to change them. But
it isn't, no. They have to change themselves.
So the book helps somebody to help themselves.
It does. I think it does.
Okay.
It's meant to be an inspirational book. A bit, you know when you look at a beautiful painting in an art gallery and you think, oh, I could do that. That's not so very hard. And it inspires that person who feels that way to go home and get the paints out and have a go. That painting has inspired them to do something similar. Or writing a book. I've just read a book by somebody else who's absolutely brilliant. And I thought, gosh, if I could have written like that, you know, wonderful. But we've each got our own styles. Do you see what I mean? when somebody does something wonderful, it's intended to inspire those who watch or listen or read to try it for themselves. So that's why I've written a book.
So the key to move up the bands that we spoke about, the between the colours of the rainbow,
be as nice as you can be,
is to find something to inspire yourself, to better yourself, to move
yeah,
on.
Yeah, absolutely, yes. And you know, we all know the commandments, judge not lest ye be judged. All right? And we all do it. We all judge. We can't help ourselves.
Matthew 7,
we would call it discernment. We give it a different name, but it's still judging. Right? We're not going to be able to stop doing that because it's part of our conditioning, in a way, to keep us safe. Right? You know, you judge somebody might be an attacker, so you stay away. That sort of thing is self-preservation. But when you catch yourself judging another for their actions, and you realise maybe it's not justifiable, turn it round and forget it and try to see them in a different light. You know, we all know people who are cross and scratchy and irritable and nasty to others. We've all met them in workplaces usually because they're under pressure, under stress, bosses on their head, on their necks and all that sort of thing. And it's easy for us to say, don't like that person, you know, they're always having a go. But if you can see them as a soul struggling with their own lives, their own reality, their souls, they need help. Once you view them with that eye, the whole picture changes. And for some reason, whether it's vibrational or what, I don't know, but that other person feels that change. And they will react differently to you. And the whole thing is transformed. And that's all it takes, is another approach to those around you. And to realise they're just souls having their journeys, and they may be having a very hard time of it. Maybe they've got somebody who beats them up at home. You don't know what's going on under the scene. So try not to be judgmental if you can. Okay. But we all will. I mean, we'll continue to do it. But catch yourself, you know, and think, oops, no, I shouldn't, you know, and try to see a different view. That, I think, is going to be very helpful to a lot of people.
Okay. We'll take a break.